By the end of this video, you'll know the different options you have to share your Fusion 360 files with others. Hey there, it's Kevin Kennedy, and welcome to episode number 16 of Fusion Fridays. One way to share a file is by creating a public link. To create a public link, you'll want to go to the File menu, hover over the Share flyout, and then select Public Link. This will open up the Share Public Link dialog, where you'll be able to toggle the link sharing on or off. When sharing is turned on, you'll be able to copy the link and send it to someone else, or paste it anywhere that someone can copy or click on the link. When someone pastes the link into their browser, they'll see the file via the Fusion 360 hub. By default, the item is downloadable. Anyone with the link will be able to click that blue download button, and they'll be able to select the Fusion 360 file type or a number of other CAD file types. After selecting a file type, they'll be prompted to enter their email, and shortly thereafter, they'll get an automated email with a downloadable file. Now, it's important to note that the file the recipient is downloading is no longer tied to your file, so you don't have to worry about them messing it up or making any changes that you don't want. Back in Fusion 360, you'll notice that I can turn the downloadable option off. I'll turn that off and refresh the web page. Now you'll see the file is view only. So this is a great way to share your file with someone if you just want them to be able to visually see it without having access to download the file. Back in Fusion 360, you'll see the last option with the Share Public Link is the option to make a password required. Now this can be useful if you need to share the file with only a specific group of people, yet you want to password protect the link in case it gets into the hands of someone else. The great thing about the public link is that the link doesn't change, and every time you save a new update to the original file, the link is automatically updated as well. So if I alter the appearance of this hairpin leg and save the file, and then refresh the web page, you'll see that the file is automatically updated. Lastly, it's important to note, if I were to turn off the Share Public Link on my end, then the file would no longer be accessible by anyone trying to get to the file via that link. It's also important to note that you can get to the Share Public Link dialog by right-clicking on that file in the Fusion 360 data panel, and then, of course, by selecting the Share Public Link option. From the File Share menu, you'll also see that you can publish your model directly to the Fusion 360 gallery. You'll be prompted to create a new project or use an existing project. And then you'll have to fill out some required info about the model. You'll also be able to choose whether people can only view the project or if they can download the files. The third option on the list, you'll see that you can also publish your files directly to GrabCAD. Now, if you're not familiar with GrabCAD, it's a site that hosts over 3 million CAD files that are all free to download and use. Publishing your projects here can be a great way to get feedback, maybe be seen by others and pick up some freelance work, or to simply contribute to the CAD community. Now, the Share Public Link is a great way to share a link to the greater community. But there is a better way to collaborate with those specifically on your team, especially for all those files that you want to keep private. You'll see that you have two tabs at the top of each project folder in the data panel. You have a data tab containing all of your design files, and you have a people tab where you can add collaborators. To invite someone, all you have to do is type out their email and click that blue invite button. Then they'll be added to the list of collaborators. As the owner of the project folder, you can remove collaborators at any time by hovering over their profile photo and clicking that remove button. Now the email recipient will get an email that looks like this. They'll need to click that blue access project button, which will lead them to the Autodesk 360 hub. From there, they'll be able to view all the files within that project folder. They'll also be able to upload files to the project folder or create new folders within that project. The details section will show you all the members of the team, which can be helpful if you're working with a larger team. The activity tab here lets you scroll through and look at all the recent activity so you can see what your collaborators have been recently working on. To take your project collaboration even further, you'll see that you can select the drop-down list in the upper right-hand corner and switch to the calendar view. Now, the calendar view is a great place to add project deadlines, meetings, or any other time-contingent details that could help your team with the design process. Below the calendar section is the discussion section. You'll see I don't have any discussions in this section, but this would be super helpful if I was working on this project with someone else. All you have to do is fill out that title and discussion description, and your team members will be notified in their alerts icon at the top every time there's a new discussion. Last but not least, you can put together wiki pages with your collaborators, which can be helpful if you need to document any parts of your process, any manufacturing details, or anything else that should be documented. One of the most beneficial things about the Autodesk 360 Hub is that you can view the files and their details right in your browser, without even having Fusion 360 open. If I click on the Hairpin Lake file again, you'll see that it opens it up and shows me some of its details. Now, I currently don't have this file used in any other files, but if I did, then they would show up right here. It would also list any 2D drawings that this file is used in. At the top, you'll notice a series of icons giving you even more options. The first button allows you to view the file directly in your browser. Now, if your file has multiple versions, you'll also be able to look back at previous versions by selecting them from this drop-down list. The pencil icon gives you the option to edit your design directly in your browser, which does have some limited functionality, or you can select Edit on Desktop, which will let you open the file directly in Fusion 360. The next icon lets you read and post comments that your collaborators can all see and respond to. Next to the comments, you'll be able to share files. The first tab is the same as the Share Public link that I discussed earlier in this video. And the second tab allows you to send the link directly to someone via email. Now the third tab, which is a bit different, allows you to embed designs directly on a website or really anywhere that an iframe is allowed. Simply click a resolution, copy the corresponding code, and paste it in where you'd like to embed your design. Looking at this hairpin leg example, you'll see I have it embedded on the Product Design Online website. So it can be pretty handy as the iframe loads the Autodesk 360 Hub, where the end user can not only view the file, but they can also inspect it and do a number of other things to it directly in the browser. Back in the 360 Hub, you'll see that the next icon lets you download many different types of CAD files. To the right of that, you can copy, move, or delete files. Last but not least, you can quickly access the Fusion 360 forums or take a tour of this 360 Hub if you forget how to navigate it. In summary, you can share public links if you want to open source your files and share them with anyone that really ends up with the link. On the other hand, you can use the Autodesk 360 Hub if you'd like to have more control over your collaborators, including more tools to help you and your team work more efficiently. Of course, the 360 Hub is the way to go if you want to keep your files private, only giving access to those you choose. Thanks for watching. If you have any questions at all about this tutorial or Fusion 360 questions in general, then be sure to comment them below. Hit that thumbs up icon if you learned something in this video and click subscribe, followed by that little bell icon to be notified of more Fusion 360 tutorials.